So yeah, I was shooting helicopters the other week for some reason I can't quite remember what, and Boris was tasting trees, and he also found the most amazing website, which included adverts for, I do believe it was 0G blowjobs. I mean, you know, this is GTA, so you know you're going to come across these things, but it always seems to be Boris who finds them.
Wait. This is slightly related. Pornhub has announced that they have interest in launching and recording a porn space. This actually made it onto my news feed, so this is serious. Yeah, and who's got more money than porn? So they might be able to.
Indeed. Yeah, yeah. Well,
what gets us to Mars? Pornhub. So I think what's happening is, through your role play, you guys are beginning to predict the future.
Oh, you might be right
now.
Yeah, yeah, you could be right there.
And somehow it's through Boris.
So, and I've been telling all my viewers, oh, the Nidd, they're fantastic people, come along, join. All you've got to do is press the join button, it's so easy.
Problem is, yeah, that now we have 300 some members, but only about 6 of them are actually active.
Well, there's more. I'd say close to 30 is on a regular basis. Yeah.
Yes, see, I got two Niddites at one point, like people to actually join the Nidd group.
Yeah.
And one of them was very active. Well, both were pretty active, but one, he got into a big fight. And I mean, he was a young kid. He got into a big fight with somebody on the Nidd public server and got really angry and ended up just like he left. He deleted his YouTube page. He deleted his Steam page. Like everything just poof was one day gone. Yeah. I'm like, what happened to this kid? You know, like, so I kind of feel bad. Like, I have one other person who he's still technically part of the Nidd, but he's not really an active Nidd member anymore. So
I swear I did.
So I'm 0 for 2. Unfortunately,
I'm sure it was Anubis's fault somewhere. It's what we.
What?
Oh God!
This kid actually came to me and asked me. Well, he's like, I'm not going on there anymore. Like, this is a bunch of bull crap. I'm like, what happened? And so I went and I talked to Boris, the first person I went to. I'm like, what happened? And he's like, no, there's a lot more to it than he's telling you. I'm like, oh, okay. And it was more just a kid being a kid.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah,
I mean,
yeah.
He was like, he was like 14 or something like that. And he was just a little overly emotional.
Yeah.
Trying to boss people around and wasn't happy when it didn't work.
Yeah.
So like I said, for me, it turns out of my Nidd suggestion, like towards people, I'm 0 for 2.
Well, I've got one of my long-term subscribers, one of my earliest, I think, a guy called Mike, he was maybe my second or third ever subscriber, was a Niddite at the point when he subscribed to my channel, and has been part of the Nidd for longer than I've known Boris.
Huh.
Yeah, Mad Mike. When I started playing with Boris, he actually left a comment on one of my videos saying, I'm so pleased you're playing with Boris. I didn't know who Boris was. I was like, really? Okay. I remember actually checking back at my channel, because when it was... because the guy called Boris, and Boris is a fairly, it's not a common name. And I remember thinking, Boris Pravisham, I know that name from somewhere. I thought, isn't he one of my subscribers? Because I remember being really excited about the fact that someone had subscribed to a channel, to my channel, who had more than 1,000 subscribers. Because after Mary with his 700 subscribers, and then Boris had subscribed a few weeks later, with 1,000 subscribers, and I was just like, oh my god. I think I phoned up my mother. Oh my god, you're never gonna believe what's happened. My poor long suffering mother, who listens to everything that my husband's not prepared to sit down and listen to.
See, it was roughly the same for me. I remember Boris messaged me. Well, because I would comment on his videos, and then one day he messaged me about he did message me, but I had commented on his video about, hey, how would I get onto the Nidd whitelist server? I would love to go on there. I liked the idea of being able to build stuff that people weren't rating.
Mm-hmm.
And out of, I think, three people who got voted on there, I was number four. And he kind of felt bad that I wasn't able to get on there. And so he was like, how about you help me with all this stuff? And like when he messaged me, I was just like, oh my God, a YouTuber messaged me. Holy crap. Like I was so excited. You know. And the only other time I've ever been that excited is another one of my subscribers, Dream Assembly. I messaged him and he messaged me back and he's got like 3,500 subscribers, something like that, 4,000. I'm just like, holy crap! Wow. Like, and he messaged me like personally, like, wow! And then he started subscribing to me, like, holy shit! So like, it was like the same feeling all over.
And then the world imploded.
Yeah.
Well, I think one of my sort of big YouTubing moments was where Avidia Zen, who's one of the Minecrackers, he's got like 100,000 subscribers. He left a comment on one of my videos, and then I would play Quake with him a few times. That was, wow. That was a big moment for me. he's gone really quiet recently, but he's fun.
I was saying this to you earlier, Hatchet, like there actually has been something I've been playing new recently, and because of all the Steam sales, I got Crysis and Crysis 2, and I have been playing the crap out of Crysis 2. Jeez. Because it looks so good on my new machine. Oh my God.
Crysis 2? What kind of a game is it?
It is a first-person semi-tactical shooter. It's basically the company that makes it is called Crytek. Crytek makes the CryEngine, and the CryEngine is the CryEngine is what they run Star Citizen.
Yes, it's the real new high-end engine. Yeah.
Crysis 2, that came out in 2011, so it's not that old a game. And I cranked it up on settings. Well, I tried Crysis first, which that came out in 2008, and I cranked that up on settings, and I'm like, it's still a decent-looking game nowadays, but you can tell it's old. So I was like, well, I'm going to... You know, I played it for a little bit, like an hour or two, and then I'm like, all right, I'm going to try Crysis 2, just see what it looks like. And I cranked it all the way up, and holy shit, does that game look good. Wow. Not to mention, there is now a Crysis 3, but DHR Mike was telling me you have to go through Origin to buy it. You can't buy it on Steam. I don't much like EA, even though I like many of their games. They're kind of like the pinnacle of an evil overlord company.
Yep.
Just, you know, feel free to read about them sometime. Yeah, but so I'm probably not going to get Crysis 3 anytime soon. But I showed my wife yesterday. I'm like, honey, you got to see how good this game looks. And she's like, I wish you could play that on the TV. And I'm like, it wouldn't look as good on the Xbox. She's like, no, not the Xbox. Just on the TV because it looks so good. I want to see it on the TV. But it's beautiful. The gameplay is pretty good. I definitely suggest giving both, because the original Crysis is a little bit more open world, while Crysis 2 is a little bit more linear. But the controls in 2 is a little bit better, and it looks stunning. And the game is just amazing. It's if you're capable of playing it, I would definitely suggest it. It's fun. The storyline is so, and the reason for that is all Crysis is just like a demonstration of the CryEngine. They're like, all right, let's slap together a patchwork story real quick to show off our awesome engine. Look at how good our water looks. Oh, the water is amazing. That's all Crysis is.
Oh dear! And if you want comedy innuendo, I think probably the best video I've seen. I mean, I started watching it because sometimes I watch in the office with my headphones on. I've got to be careful about how much I snigger. And I'd watched maybe 2 minutes of this particular episode, and I had to switch off and go somewhere private. Was Boris's Mount Your Friends, where they are talking about north facing wood. Oh boy, it is astonishingly
I don't even
funny.
Like that game, but I watched that with my wife.
Yeah,
and like it's just so funny. I can't help but laugh every damn episode. That is, I have zero interest in playing that game, but I will watch them play that every time they put out episode.
Yeah, absolutely.
So funny.
As soon as you see one coming out, it's like, oh, the comedy's about to start.
Well, Well, yeah. I saw it on, if you guys know Markiplier, like, I saw him and some of his YouTubing friends, like, play that, and I'm like, that is the most ridiculous, and I think that's one of the games I didn't let my daughter watch, like,
yeah
she doesn't need to see the Speedos swinging around.
Well, that's what's funny about Anubis, is he plays the safe game mode with the zippers, but he's playing it with Boris and Apple. It's like, how is that going to help? Just replacing it with zippers.